making a chopped orange cardamom porter today. I've never made it before. So I made a porter, obviously. It's got a lot of chocolate malt in the recipe. It's got 4% brown, 4% pale chocolate, and 4% chocolate malt. I'm adding some orange peel and some cardamom just at the end of the boil. So I'll get a lot of chocolate in there from the malt, but what we're going to do is during the fermentation, we'll add some cacao nibs. I'll have to roast them up to try to... Apparently it's not very soluble, the chocolate flavours, until you roast them up, and that solubilises them, and the alcohol will help bring out the chocolate flavour.
Yes. And you know the other cool thing about chocolate as well that influences the chocolate flavour that you might not be aware of is the pH. There seems to be a really common thing at the moment that brewers, when they're making dark beers and they're using roast malts, that they don't want that burnt, acrid, astringent kind of flavour in their beer. And so what they do is they'll actually go and take the roast malts and they'll steep it in cold water and not in the main mash. To try and avoid those roasty, burnt, acrid, burnt toast kind of flavours.
Yep.
But rather than doing that, my advice to you is to do what the chocolate makers do, and they do a process called dutching, which is where they roast the chocolate at a much higher pH. And so that actually makes the chocolate taste a lot smoother and chocolatey and rich and that sort of thing. And you can actually achieve the same thing yourself when you're all grain brewing, simply by lifting the pH of the mash. And so this comes back to water chemistry again. So it's a game of opposites. If you're mashing all pale malt, so let's say you're making a pilsner or a pale ale or something like that, the pH of the mash and the wort will be very high, and you need to add salts and acid to bring the pH down to where it needs to be. Roast malts are acidic, but they benefit from a mash with a higher pH, so you've got to kind of flip it around the other way. You've got to raise the mash pH, so around 5.5, even up to 5.6 for your mash pH. Makes it taste really smooth.
You know, from experience, I have found that if I have the mash pH at 5.2, it's just not as smooth a chocolate flavour. So I've added a little bit of bicarb soda, so that's going to increase the pH a little bit. I like a little bit of sodium from the sodium bicarb because it does sort of add to that sweetness and rounds out that chocolate flavour. It's only a small amount, but I suspect I'm about 5.5.
That's a very good point. So yes, bicarb soda is a really good way to raise your mash pH. It's also very safe for using at home. You can use things like calcium hydroxide is it also another way to raise the mash pH. Another chemical you can use is sodium hydroxide or caustic or drain cleaner. I've done it. You've all drunk the bloody beers and you're not dead yet. it's very potent, so be very sparing. So you've also got to be very careful with it when it's in its concentrated form. But you can go and buy from the supermarket, and they probably sell it here as well, as sodium hydroxide. That if you go buy the one that's, they say, for making soap, that doesn't, because drain cleaner can sometimes have aluminium flecks in it, and you obviously don't want aluminium going into your beer. But if you have straight lye, that's correct, then that will actually help to raise your mash pH. And seriously, in a 20 litre batch, like not even a quarter of a teaspoon or something like that. But if you have a pH meter, you can measure and that sort of thing. And that's how you make your dark beers taste really rich and roasty and chocolatey. But sometimes you actually want that burnt, acrid kind of flavour. And to give an example of a beer that's dark and has that nice roasty, burnt, acrid flavour, Guinness, right? Dry Irish Stout. So they're specifically soured to bring out those flavours. So it's as a brewer, you can play these things any way you want. It's fascinating. So yeah.
Every year in May, hundreds of beer-related venues right across Melbourne and Victoria take part in Good Beer Week. Grain and Grape has long been associated with this festival. The past few years have seen us go with a carnival theme. I guess that explains Hendo's hat. During our Carnival of the Brew, we get a bunch of professional brewers together with savvy home brewers to demonstrate all the different ways you can make beer at home. It's a fun day. See the description below for more details.